Careblazer, most of us have heard about foods, exercise, puzzles, and other things that can protect our brain from dementia. But for the first time in history, we are now facing something totally new, something our parents and our grandparents never had to think about. It's called artificial intelligence, AI, and it could affect our brain health for better or for worse. I'm Dr. Natali Edmonds, a board-certified geropsychologist, and here at Dementia Careblazers, our mission is to build the world's most trusted dementia caregiving community for family caregivers. Okay, so let's talk about why artificial intelligence might be something that matters to caregivers. I actually thought this was a topic most of you wouldn't be interested in because I was thinking, I wonder how many of my viewers actually use AI. And this past Monday, in one of our support groups for the Care Collective, I started talking to some of my members about this study that I'm going to share with you. And I was shocked to learn about just how some of you are actually using AI. So that made me decide to publish this video. I'm actually curious, do you use AI, artificial intelligence, ChatGPT, Microsoft Copilot, anything like that? If so, leave it in a comment below. Okay, now back to this important topic about preventing dementia. By the time you reach the age of 85, half of the people will develop dementia. So one out of every two people will develop dementia at the age of 85. The biggest risk factor for developing dementia is age, meaning the older you are, the higher your likelihood of developing the condition. This is not to scare you. This is to drive home the point about how important it is for us to do whatever we can to prevent dementia. It's basically about why it's so important to do what we can to protect our brains now, because the changes that happen in dementia happen in our brains decades before we start to show the symptoms. So, truly, whatever you are doing today is going to make an impact on your brain and the behaviors and symptoms you have 10, 20 years from now. And many of the Careblazers I talk to are actually concerned for their own brain health. Will I get it? Am I next? Dementia runs in my family. Am I guaranteed to develop this? One of the protective factors against dementia, meaning it protects our brain from developing it, is lifelong learning. Basically, when we challenge our brain through learning new things, it creates new neural connections. It's like we're adding more roads and bridges to a city. So instead of just having one main road to a destination, we have all these other roads to a destination. So it means if one road is shut down, we can still get to our destination. We still have flow. We can still reach our goal. So if we think about this in terms of the neural pathways in our brain, if something's happening to one neural pathway, ideally, this lifelong learning that builds new pathways in our brain, our brain can still compensate. It can still make adjustments and do what we're wanting it to do. So researchers from MIT recently did a study and they looked at, is AI actually hurting our brain? They particularly looked at an AI source called ChatGPT. And they wanted to know what happens to people's brains when they use AI versus no help versus a regular Google search on the internet. So what they did is they divided people into these three groups: AI, Google, and no, their own brain, no outside help. And they measured their brain waves with an EEG, and they had them write essays. And what an EEG does is it shows how active and connected your brain is while you're thinking, kind of like you might consider an EKG for measuring your heart rhythm. This is like EEG for your brain waves. What they found is that the group who did the essay alone without any Google or AI, they had the highest brain activity. Those who used Google as a search engine, they had the middle ground of brain activity. And those who used AI had the least amount of brain activity during the task of writing the essays. Think about it like exercise. If you always took the elevator instead of taking stairs, your legs eventually weaken. In the same way, outsourcing our own thinking to AI is basically giving our brain fewer workouts, weakening our brain. Not only that, people who wrote their essays without AI actually had better memory of what they wrote, and they felt more of an ownership for what they did. Versus the people who used ChatGPT often couldn't even recall anything they had written. Almost as if we hired somebody to do our workouts for us, we don't actually get the benefit of lifting the weight. So why does this matter in terms of dementia prevention? Every time we learn, we solve problems, we stretch our mind, our brain is creating these new pathways. And as we age and start to lose neurons, especially if we're starting to develop dementia, we are going to damage some roads. But if we've built enough of these backup roads, our brain can keep finding detours. But if we start to let AI do too much of our heavy lifting, we're going to miss out on building those protective connections. Now, this does not mean to not use AI if you're using it. I personally use it for many different things, but it just means we want to be careful in how we are using it. So, one idea is if you are going to use AI to help you with, let's say, writing something like in this study, you would want to start with your own ideas first. Write out your own ideas, your own theories, put some paragraphs together, and ask AI to maybe help polish it or expand it or critique it or give it pros and cons so that you still have to use your brain to actually pull it all together. Now, if you've never used AI and you're kind of curious about, well, what could I use AI for? Let me give you a couple caregiver-friendly ideas that won't lead to brain rot, as some people call it. One idea would be to help brainstorm activities that you could do with your loved one, and then adapt one that you could use between you and your loved one. So you might be able to tell AI, oh, my loved one has difficulties with walking and balance, but he likes to move and be engaged in activity. What sorts of activities can you come up with? And it's kind of like using it as a creative jump off. Another way that is a great way that you could try using AI would be, let's say you are learning a new medical term or a new area of the brain, or the doctor gave you a summary, or you have even notes printed out from your loved one's medical records, and you see something in it that you don't understand or a word you don't know, and you want to learn more about it, you can put that into AI and have it learn and teach you. And then you can try to, summarize it back in your own words to help make sure you understood. Now, that's a brain-promoting activity with using AI. For a super quick tip, not necessarily promoting brain new pathways, but also not hurting them, you could also use AI to help you come up with easy crockpot meal recipes for the week that save time. I just recently had a house full of seven people, and I certainly turned to AI to help me find crowd-pleasing meals that would likely have leftovers that didn't require me to stand in front of the stove the whole time. And that was actually quite helpful. I've made two new recipes I had never made before that were a big hit. Okay, Careblazer, I would love to hear from you. Do you use AI like ChatGPT, Alexa, or other smart tools at all, either in your caregiving or in your daily life or your work life? Let us know below. I'm also wondering, do you feel like it has helped you, or do you feel like it's more worrisome to you? I think the researchers of this article, which I will link the full article below so you can click on it, I think one of the things that authors are cautioning against is we are releasing so much technology so quickly and we don't fully understand all of the consequences or side effects of that technology. And so they're just cautioning us to be aware of what we are using. Bottom line, do not outsource your critical thinking to a machine because that critical thinking is actually helping lower your risk of dementia in the future. And so now the question is, will AI increase dementia in the future if too many people are using it, relying on it too much for the deep thought work? All right, Careblazers, your brain health matters just as much as your loved ones. Keep learning, keep stretching, and hopefully using tools to make our life easier in a way that helps us. So, that's what I have for you today. If you are new here, please hit that red subscribe button. It is totally free. And in fact, YouTube will go out and put our videos in front of another caregiver in the world who has no idea we exist. And that's super important to me to let more dementia caregivers who are looking for help actually be able to find trustworthy, science-backed, evidence-based help. So when you click the red subscribe button, that's how it helps us as a channel and helps us grow. And in fact, YouTube tells us that the majority of you watching our videos are not subscribed at all. So it really does mean a lot, not so much for me and vanity numbers, but for actually reaching more people who are looking for messages like this. Make sure you check the description below this video where you can find links to upcoming free live classes, including how you can win an entire year scholarship to our Care Collective program, where you can get access to weekly support groups and Q&A sessions with experts and so much more. All right, that's what I have for you today, Careblazer. Bye.
Also, Nico gets a belly rub for every person who subscribes from this video. So if you haven't already, click the red subscribe button. It's totally free. And Nico says thank you very much.